Good morning. This is another broadcast of Chatting from the Chair with your host, Oscar York. I first like to say that it have been a great privilege to be with you every week as we broadcast or air our show on every Monday. I first like to thank those that have been watching me and this show very, very faithfully, and we hope and pray that this show has been beneficial to you and that you have went away learning something that maybe you did not know or maybe on the topics that we are discussing. Maybe you have a thought on it and that you want me to know about it. Please, if you do, send me an email. Chat with me on Facebook and let me know your thoughts on the things that we have been chatting on for the past 2 months. I am so delighted about that we have been on now for 2 months, and I hope and pray that you are benefiting from this show. Secondly, I'd like to thank those that are watching the show for the first time. We hope and pray that since this is your first time that you gain something from today's show, and that you may recap on other shows and watch those too. They will always be there on YouTube for you to watch. And then I like to say this. If at any time that you agree with what your brother is saying here, give me a thumbs up. It's not too many that's giving me a thumbs up. Give me a thumbs up. And if you are disagreeing with me, give me a thumbs down. You know, it's always good to have feedback back, whether it be good or whether it be bad. Give me some feedback so that your brother here may know what he's doing right or what he's doing wrong. And thirdly, I like to say, subscribe to my show. We've had many views, but not too many subscribers. I don't know what the problem is. Maybe some of you think since you subscribe to other shows that you don't have to subscribe to this one. Each show you must subscribe to. So we want to ask that you subscribe to our show, Chatting from the Chair. And again, we like to pray for those who was in the way or pathway of the recent hurricanes and storms that we've been having. Harvey up in Texas, Irma up in Florida, and now Jose is coming through. We want to pray for those that have been caught in the way of these storms and these hurricanes. We know that it is not easy, and we know that the aftermath is not as easy as it seems to go through. So we want to pray for those that are going through those storms, and even pray for those that are going through some problems in this life. You know, sometimes this life is not always easy to live. That's why Christ died for the body of Christ. Will you pray with me, please? Our Father, which art in heaven, Father, we come to you in the most humblest way we know how, thanking you, Father, for waking us up this morning. Thank you, Father, for blessing us to see a day that none of us have never witnessed before. Oh, Father, we thank you for that, Father. We thank you, Father, for each member that are watching this show, Father. We pray, Father, that you be with them and guide them, strengthen them, allow them to know, Father, that you are God and that you are Jehovah Jireh, that you provide, Father. Father, help us when we are going the crooked way. Make our way straight, Father. Help us, Father, when there's a stumbling block in our way. Don't remove them, but just help us, Father, that we may be able to go through them. Pray, Father, for those who are having difficulties, whether it's financial, whether it's marriage, whether it's problem with the children, whether it's just problems on the job. We pray for that they may overcome those problems, or, Father, that you help them to go through those problems. Father, we pray for those that are bounded by prison bars. Father, we pray, Father, that they still get to know you, even though they're behind the prison bars. Father, we're praying for those that are not in the best of health. Father, we pray that you heal them if it be your will. But Father, if it's not your will, allow them to still recognize that you are God, and beside thee, there's no other. In Jesus' blessed name do we pray. Amen and amen. Like I said, I'm so thankful for you all that have joined our show today and are watching. And we hope and pray that this show have been very beneficial to you. On this morning, I like to do a change up. I never allow no one to know my stance on things. And this is basically, where I'm discussing things. You may know how I believe and my stance is. And this is something I would never change because the scriptures bear it out. Your brother here believes truly that there's only one way to get to heaven. And that have been, and that is through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Even if you go back and look in the Old Testament and study that, you will even see, you will even see that our Lord had only one way, one nation, one people. And that was the children of Israel that came through the seed of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. You see, so that was only one way. And that is only one way today. And that is through the body of Christ. My friend, I know many might be disagreeing with me, but Christ died on the cross so that you and I may have a chance at eternal life. Christ died on the cross so that we may have a chance at grace to be saved. It's only through his grace that we are saved. See, Romans 3:23 says, "For we all have sinned and come short of God's glory." My friend, it is Christ's gift to us to be saved through him. And it's up to each and every one of us to accept his gift. So on this morning, I want to talk about the many ways or the many signs of false teaching or false teachers. Because there are many teaching falsehood in the world. Not only in the world, even in the body of Christ. There are many that are teaching their way and not Christ's way. So in this morning, this teaching this morning, I want you to open your Bibles and study with me. Because this lesson might take some time for us to cover, and we hope and pray you dig deep into it, and if there are any questions, as I said, please let me know. So this morning we want to discuss these false teachers. You know, Christ talked about false teachers. Christ talked about how we can identify these false teachers. If you will, please turn with me, and we probably just have time to read this, and I guarantee on my next show we will dive more into it. But here in Matthew 23, and we want to do a good study on this, because I believe that salvation is important. I believe that no one in their right mind, right heart, right soul, wants to go to H-E-L-L, hell. I truly believe that we all want to go to heaven. So read with me real quick. And I just want to read a few verses, because I see, watching the time, that I'm running out. But Jesus says this, and this is Jesus speaking. This is no one else speaking but Jesus. And I believe we should listen to Jesus, not what we think. Not even the commentaries. But this is what Jesus said. He said in Matthew chapter 23, starting with verse 1, "Then spake Jesus to the multitude and to his disciples, saying, The scribes and the Pharisees sit in Moses' seat. All therefore whatsoever they bid you observe, that observe and do. But do not ye after their works, for they say and do not, for they bind heavy burdens and grievous to be borne, and lay them on men's shoulders, but they themselves will not move them with one of their fingers. For all their works they do to be seen of men. They make broad their phylacteries and enlarge the borders of their garments, and love the uppermost rooms and feasts, and the chief seats in the synagogues, and greetings in the markets, and to be called of men, Rabbi, Rabbi. But be ye not ye called Rabbi, for one is your master, even Christ, and all of ye are brethren. And call no men your father upon the earth, for one is your father which is in heaven." If you're taking notes, and if you want to outline this lesson, your topic should be the signs of false teachers or teaching. And you should have Roman number 1. And under that Roman number 1, you should have number one, false teachers. And then we have a A, B, and a C. So this is what we're going to be discussing for the next couple of shows. How can we tell a sign or a trait of false teaching? I'm going to wind it up here, and like I said, next Monday we will begin with this section on false teachers or teaching. Before I leave, I'd like to ask everyone, as always, visit my web page, visit my online bookstore, order you a book. I'm launching my new book, though I've been advertising it for quite some time. That is Bridges of Friendships. Get you a copy of that. We are getting ready to make a mixed launch of that book and get you a copy of that book. It's a great story. And read. I believe that with reading, there is knowledge. And when there is knowledge, there is power. And as always, I love you. And God, do too. Have a grand day.